Hi, I'm Erin with Homeschool Connections, and we're here today with Dr. Sam Nicholson. Sam, great to have you here.
Hi, Erin. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. And I am anxious to hear about your courses. I know you teach a number of courses here at Homeschool Connections. Tell us about those.
So I teach philosophy to high schoolers here at Homeschool Connections. I've been teaching for about 4 years here. And right now there are about 12 courses that are available online. Mm-hmm. And I also have one logic series that I'm in the process of teaching, and that will span four different classes over 2 different years.
Incredible. These are
courses planned and just I'm very active, you know, planning new courses and trying to add to what's available.
I was just going to say that. So you have courses here in recording. You're also doing brand new courses every year that are fresh with the live classes as well. So you could take courses recorded and live with you. Yeah, tell us about some of those specific courses, maybe your favorite courses to teach. I know probably you like them all, but maybe pick a few to tell us about.
Well, right now I'm teaching logic courses, and those mm-hmm. are a little bit different from your typical philosophy class, because we're looking more at imparting a skill as opposed to communicating information about, you know, who said what at certain points in time. And the skill that we're really trying to get across is just the ability to think clearly and with precision, and to identify cogent and fallacious forms of reasoning. And fortunately, this is a topic that's much neglected at the high school level. Many people postpone it until they get to college. Mm-hmm. And so I think it's vitally important that it be available for high school students. Mm-hmm. And I've actually taken some of my experience teaching this at the college level, and I've adapted it to a high school curriculum in mm-hmm. a way that I think was kind of plugging a gap in what I saw in the typical logic curriculum.
I completely agree with you. Logic is such a valuable skill for all of life, and particularly for the high school student going into college, to have that before you get to college and able to think through the logical fallacies and how to think clearly. So important today. Tell me about another course. I know that your philosophy courses cover a lot of different topics and subjects as well. Tell me about those.
Yeah, so in addition to the logic courses, I have some courses that are topical. So one, for example, we discuss virtue and vice. And so we look through different theories of what it means to give to live a good life. And so we will go back through some of the ancient philosophers, and we will combine this with insights from traditional moral theology, and then look at some contemporary approaches so that we have a good sense of what is at stake. For example, when people get into disputes over what it means to be happy, or what it means to be free, or what it is that's worth doing with your life. And I try to combine in these classes both classical and historical readings, as well as provide an emphasis on arguments, so that people can see not just who said what, but what are the reasons for believing this? Why do we think this?
So valuable. As a parent whose kids are grown and gone now, thinking back, I would have loved to have my kids in your courses to be able to learn these reasoning skills and to get that strong foundation. I can't underscore this enough. I've also been a college and university professor. The ability to think clearly that comes through these courses is so, so important. That's phenomenal. Tell me about you and your background and what unique skills you bring to be able to teach these courses.
Yeah, so I've taught at the university level for about 12 years, both as a teaching assistant, and then I was a full professor for several years. And I got to teach both at the big state schools and at local community colleges. And during that same time period, I also did a little bit of high school teaching for a local homeschool co-op. And so when the opportunity came up to teach for Homeschool Connections, I really jumped at it because I enjoyed teaching that cohort of students. And I would say that actually of all the groups of students that I've taught, I have enjoyed teaching, you know, Catholic high schoolers more than any. And so the opportunity to teach them this subject matter and to see them being engaged with it is just a really special treat.
And you bring such skill when in your background, teaching background. It's just for those parents watching, if you are looking for an instructor who has been a teacher at both the high school all the way through college level and knows what we need in the college level, that's the great skill that you bring in particular, is you've been and are in the university college level and know exactly what the student needs to succeed there. So I just want to highlight that, because that's just so valuable to parents and families and kids.
Yeah, and I want to say that part of it too is born through trial and error. And so what you're getting here with some of these Homeschool Connections classes is the culmination of over a decade having experience seeing what works and what doesn't.
Right.
And so really, you've skipped some of the trial and error phase in my teaching development process. And so you're kind of the output of that.
That's now. Right. You get the smooth teacher.
You're looking to sign up for one of my courses.
That's awesome. That's awesome. Tell us a little bit about you personally and give us a little window into who you are with your family and your home life.
Well, my wife is also a teacher for Homeschool Connections, Eleanor Nicholson, and she's an aspiring novelist. She's got a well-regarded Catholic vampire novel, which was published recently with the Ignatius Press. And she's a specialist in Victorian literature. And so her classes usually appear, and oftentimes we'll be juggling our four kids as we, you know, run upstairs. She'll come down here and teach on the computer, and then I'll, you know, play zone defense to keep them away from the basement door while she's doing her thing. And we both really enjoy it. And in addition, we also both work at our local parish. So I, believe it or not, do building maintenance is my day job. So we're at a large Catholic parish in Virginia. And I take care of the facilities and the building, and she does religious education.
That's awesome that you guys work together. That's great. Go ahead.
Yeah, and it's just great that we have an integrated Catholic home life, and we really try to emulate the notion of the domestic church. And it's just a blessing to be able to do both this kind of more service-oriented job that I have during the day for the parish. And it's, you know, perfectly, you know, delightful to be able to in there and interact with the priests, because we're a Dominican run parish, and then to come home and then to still have these opportunities to teach and do the things that
right.
I when I was in the university system.
Right. I have to ask, do you guys ever think you'll be writing a book together?
Oh, I don't know about that. First, we're in different subjects, and even right. within the subjects where our interests overlap, we don't have the same tastes. So my wife and I are never going to agree on I like a dead Russian. She's just not into Russian.
Oh, funny.
So well, sometimes we can talk about some things, but then there are others where we just are at an impasse. So it's very unlikely to do a joint effort.
Anytime. That's fun. I had to ask. Yeah. All right. So if parents want to know more about your courses and exactly what's in the courses, I know that at the homeschoolconnections.com website, homeschoolconnectionsonline.com, there are two catalogs. There's a recorded catalog for your recorded courses and a live catalog where they'll find where they could jump in a live interactive course with you. If they wanted to get a hold of you personally and touch bases with you on email, what's a great way to reach out to you?
Well, the best contact for me would be the following email address is scn8v@virginia.edu. And I check that daily. And if you get in touch with me and ask about one of my courses, I will give you prompt replies. So
awesome.
That's the best contact.
Tell us one more time those letters.
S
email.
C as in cat, 8, the number 8, V as in Victor, @virginia.edu.
Wonderful. I just want to make sure people were able to check it back again after they wrote it the first time. So awesome. Thank you so much for taking time to just talk a little bit about your classes and who you are and your teaching and your background. It's just really a delight to have you here as an instructor. And I just can't wait to see what happens in the future with the new courses that you're developing as well.
All right. Well, thank you, Erin.
All right. And if you're watching this and have any questions, please do reach out to us. And we do hope to see you in class soon.